fans believe that they figured out exactly who is going to survive out of all the villains in Spider-Man No Way Home. And they've done this through detective work by watching the other films. I think that's how they did it anyway. So multiple fan sites, theories, Reddit posts, internet discussions have all, I guess, sort of come to the same conclusion. That when it comes to which villains will survive and which ones will die in this multiverse film, there seems to be a consensus that we already know how exactly this plays out. And that's through watching the other films. Essentially, what they figured out is, well, if Willem Dafoe is back, and he's the Green Goblin, well, the Goblin doesn't come back after his death in the Raimi films, and he's brought into this. So if he's pulled out at the moment of his death, and then he doesn't come back again, that means he probably dies in No Way Home. Same thing with other characters, like Sandman, for example, can be alive. But somebody like Doc Ock can't, because he's restored right back into that heroic moment at the end of Spider-Man 2. Then you have a character like the Lizard, which we know his fate, so there you go with that one. He just gets put back into lockup. Maybe it's the man with a hat or something. We don't know. Maybe they'll pick up on that thread at some point. Electro, he was sort of disintegrated, but he's at electricity, pure energy, so he's definitely still alive, so you can play with that, and maybe that's how it's brought into this. So essentially, people believe that a major spoiler is the fate of these characters and what happens with them and their appearances in the other films will dictate exactly what happens with them in this new film. And while that could be a case, is it really though? Because from everything we're seeing, they're not exactly the same characters. Like, Electro is not the same Electro. Like, they've explicitly said he's not going to be that blue energy surging version. Like, he's different. So we don't know the full extent of where they're from and if they're from the same multiverse. Like, it seems kind of lazy that they're just going to pull the same characters from the same movies we've seen. Like, the multiverse is so vast that you pull the ones we've already seen. Wow. What a coincidence, right? I think there's got to be more creativity here. Maybe one or two of the villains will be the ones we've seen. I would say probably Lizard and Doc Ock are the ones, and the others, well, they'll be from elsewhere, and they're kind of loosely the versions we've seen before, and that would work with me and I think most people, because you can't just toss the same versions in for everything. That just cheapens the value. So I guess in due time we'll know. I mean, for all we know, we're going to come back to this after we see the film and go, oh, wow, that theory was right. That's exactly how they handle all of them, which I guess could be the case. But something tells me they're not going to be that unoriginal.